What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Alex DeVries. Right off the bat, huge thank you to everyone who liked, commented, subscribed, and even watched the first two videos of me and Will in New York. It was a super fun time making that. But this video is going to be a full day of eating. Right now I'm in a bulk, so the diet that I'm going to show you today is different than what I did on the summer. Over the summer, I went on a massive cut. I got down to roughly 150 pounds. I got super shredded. I will show you a picture of what I look like right here. So I don't look like that right now, but we're still getting there. You know, it's like a lean bulk. Right now I'm about 160, so I'm about 10 pounds up from where I was. And yeah, so with all that being said, let's get right into it to meal number one. So as you guys just saw, that was not that much work for a pretty hefty breakfast. The only really hard part is making the eggs, because I do them soft scrambled. So like, shout out Gordon Ramsay, because I learned how to make soft scrambled eggs this way. But you basically just put it on the heat, you keep stirring basically the entire time, and you take it off the heat for like 15 seconds and then on the heat for 15 seconds. You just keep doing that until they look something like that. If you like soft scrambled, or if you've never had them, give them a shot. But so we got four whole eggs, a cup and a half of egg whites, 250 grams to be exact. We got two pieces of toast. Instead of using normal butter, I recommend you get the I Can't Believe It's Not Butter, the spray kind. Saves you a ton of calories for the same flavor. So we got two pieces of toast. And we have this oatmeal, which has just regular oats, 45 grams. 112 grams of blueberries, and then I put 15 grams of PB Fit in it as well. If people are trying to lose fat or trying to lose weight, cut peanut butter out of your diet completely. It has so many calories, so much fat, and switch it out for the PB Fit instead. It's basically a percentage of the calories. Like a full tablespoon of peanut butter is like 200, 250 calories, something like that. And then the PB Fit, like a full serving is like, which is like 60 calories or something like that. So way healthier, you get the same flavor profile. So make that switch and I guarantee you will see progress, whether you're trying to lose weight or whatever your goal is. So we're gonna munch on this for a little bit and then we're gonna go to the gym. I'm training legs today, and at the gym, I will explain my whole training routine. I will record my leg workout. And I'll bring some of my other meals on the go with me, since I obviously can't cook at the gym. So I'll see you then. All right, so 3 minutes later, I finished the breakfast, but I thought I should tell you guys like the macros. And if you don't know what macros are, that means macronutrients, and you really should only track through your protein, your fat, and your carbs. So for those of you that didn't know, now you know. So for that whole entire monstrosity of a breakfast, that is 730 calories, 65 carbs, 24 fat, and 62 protein. So pretty good way to start the day. A good rule of thumb for people out there is if you're trying to bulk up or build muscle or even lose weight, but you want to maintain muscle, you should always track your protein. And a good rule of thumb is try to get at least a gram per pound of body weight. So if you're 150 pounds, try to get 150 grams of protein in per day, and you won't lose any muscle that way. So, but if you're trying to bulk up, I always say that's like the minimum, but always like shoot above that. So like right now, my protein intake is probably 250 around there. And like, obviously I don't weigh 250 pounds. If you thought that, then you're wrong. So yeah, what? We have this little special guest right now. It is my dog, Mandy, which if for those of you who already know her, you know she's not the nicest, so let's see if she's friendly on camera.
Hey. Hey. What are you doing? Oh, with the camera. This is Mandy. You wanna do anything?
No, she's a couch potato. She don't really do much, but all right. So now I will go get ready to go to the gym and pack my meals and get my computer and everything. And then there I will train legs and explain my training and show you the rest of the meals throughout the day. So I'll see y'all then. All right. So before we head out, just a little tip for those of you who hate vegetables like me. What I usually do, instead of just like eating broccoli with every meal, I take a green supplement, which is something like this. It's just like powdered green. So on my way to work, I'll usually put that in a 32-ounce bottle, just like this Gatorade one. And I'll drink that on the way to work. And that covers my greens for the day. So, I mean, they taste pretty good. It kind of almost tastes like lemon tea almost. So it's not bad, but... So yeah, just a little tip for those of you who hate vegetables, get something like that, it'll keep you covered and you'll be straight. So, there you go. All right, so we're still not at the gym, clearly. So what I decided to do was just, you know, I thought, you know, why don't I space out my meals, go to the gym a little bit later, that way I can get a pre-workout meal in. So that's what we're doing. So right now we got meal number two of the day, which is very basic, pretty boring, but you know, it gets the job done. It's just chicken and rice. I don't know how well that's coming out, but you know, it's good. I mean, it kind of sucks eating it every single day, but let me see if I can find the macros for this. I don't know if I have this saved. By the way, if you haven't already, download MyFitnessPal. You can track all your calories, get all your macros that way. So this meal is about 540 calories total. 58 grams of carbs, just over 4.5 grams of fat, and 57 protein. So pretty good macros, very good macros actually. So to talk about dieting a little bit, if you were trying to lose weight, most important thing is that you need to be in a caloric deficit, meaning you need to eat less calories than you burn. If you do that, there's no way that you're not going to lose weight. While you're in a deficit, that's when it's important to keep track of your protein, because if you're in a deficit, you want to get as much protein as possible. That way you can maintain your muscle still. So say like if you bulk, right? So like right now I'm 10 pounds up from where I started in the summer. So I've added on, you know, some fat and some muscle as well. But when I cut down the road, which isn't going to be for a while, but when I cut, you know, my protein intake is still going to be relatively high, even though I'm going to be in a caloric deficit. That way I hold on to all the muscle that I've built, but I lose all the fat around it. I mean, obviously you're still going to lose some muscle, but you know, not all of it's going to go away. So that is key, but I'm going to munch on this and then immediately head to the gym this time and get ready to hit legs. So I'll see y'all there. All right, what up, everyone? Just got to the gym, about to hit legs. Got one of my boys with me.
What's up? I'm Chen, 16-year-old powerlifter. Gonna do a cool leg day with Alex today. Yeah, let's kick it.
You don't do the hand thing.
That was pretty cool, though. That should be pretty.
Right? It's smooth, right? I mean, so yeah, we're about to hit legs, and he's more of a powerlifter. I'm more of a bodybuilder, so we'll see who does better. I mean, I know he's stronger. But who looks better, you know? You know the vibes.
Just to feel something, yeah, I give everything, just to feel something, just to feel something.
Alright, so this kid just did my pyramid set on leg extensions. How's it feel?
Bro, my legs are on fire.
Stand up.
Never again, bro.
Stand up.
Shit. Dude, I can't.
Yeah, I tried squatting and doing all of this.
This kid got monster quads. I wish my legs looked like that.
Fuck.
I know how to train legs, but mine won't grow for some reason. So, shitty. All right, big shout out to this kid right here. What's your name?
Dennis.
What's your Instagram?
DennisMino.2019.
You heard it here, folks. Everyone go follow him. 15 years old, strong as hell. Sky's the limit for him. All right, that concludes the workout. Big shout out to Chen. I'm trying to convert him to the dark side of bodybuilding. He's a power lifter right now, so I'm trying to convert him. Stay tuned for later. I'll explain my whole training and my whole regimen, so stay tuned for that. All right, so after that disgustingly brutal leg day, post-workout meal, something called cream of wheat. I don't know if any of you have ever had it, but it's basically just this like mushy, like I know it looks like vomit and looks disgusting, but it's so good. Pretty healthy too. It's literally just straight carbs. And then we have two scoops of Ghost vegan protein. Their whey one is way better, but it is naughty to my stomach, so I do not eat it. So the vegan one, same amount of protein and stuff, but it's just, it settles in my stomach a little bit better, you know? So that's gonna be meal number three of the day, post workout, and then we gotta go home and eat another pretty basic yet filling meal. So I'll see y'all then. Thank you.
All right, so I'm getting ready for the last meal of the day, which is gonna be another 160 grams of chicken, 2 pieces of toast with some of that, this right here, some of this, I can't believe it's not butter, and 116 grams of blueberries. So usually while my toast is cooking, I'll munch on these and then I'll microwave my chicken. For this, I actually make the chicken. It's ground chicken. I make it into little sandwiches, like patties, and then I just eat it like a sandwich, you know? So that's what I do for this. So I'm gonna start mucking on some blueberries. Ready for this action? Beautiful. So another really good tip for people to change, it's a minor change in their diet, is stop buying things with a lot of fat and sugar. So, you know, when you go grocery shopping and start looking for things that are sugar-free or fat-free, you're gonna save yourself a ton of calories and you're gonna be just a little bit healthier than the way you are now. So there's a little tip for you. Like, for example, I start getting sugar-free ketchup from now on. I did that all over the summer. I mean, granted, it still tastes like ketchup, but it's a little bit healthier, so the amount. I absolutely love ketchup. By no means am I like Patrick Mahomes, who puts ketchup on everything. There are some things where if you put ketchup on it, it's like a sin. Like, you're going straight to hell if you put ketchup on your mac and cheese or your eggs. I think that's just, you're not right in the head if you do that. But I do put it on things like steak, always use it on chicken. You know, fries, tater tots, obviously, like, those are like normal things to use ketchup on, but yeah, I guess the weirdest one for me would be steak. Steak is by far the weirdest thing to, that I put ketchup on, but not for everyone. But comment below, let me know, what's your favorite condiment and why? And what's the weirdest thing that you put it on? Let me know.
Bam.
I know, it's beautiful, right? Like I said, nothing special, but you know, gets the job done, hits my macros for the day, tons of protein. A lot of carbs and not a lot of fat, so you know. So we're gonna muck on this, and then that'll be all the meals for the day, all 5 meals. So, all right, everyone. So that concludes the full day of eating. Please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, even turn on the notification bell. Show your friends, tell your friends that I'm trying out this whole YouTube thing. It really means a lot, and it helps me out a ton. Please, if you want, leave a comment. And give me some ideas for what kind of videos you guys want to see. I'm thinking about some food challenges, fitness challenges, more kind of day in the life videos, explain a little bit about maybe my background, why I started lifting, what sports I grew up playing, what my first 2 years of college were like, literally anything, right? So just give me ideas of what you guys want to see, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.